indeed from the morning on. You know, we were discussing this in closing bell yesterday that don't expect a large FI number because the cash market volumes were so low. From the view inside the concept of now that it's 1,000 points only. But look, I was looking at the delivery-based data. There was only, there were only two stocks where you saw delivery-based buying, HDFC and Sun Pharma. And look at the top gainer yesterday, Bank of Baroda, only had 10% delivery volumes yesterday. So the sense is that the shortcut in house is done. If the market moves on even from here on, then you just can't say that it was short-covering. Then you have to say, okay, the market maybe made a bit of a bottom and it has now seen a bit of buying. So that's something that we'll find out over the next few or 4 days. If the Nifty takes out, say, 8450 or so, 8450 is now seen as the next key resistance mark because technically that also represents about 40-50% retracement of the last round. That is where the Nifty normally struggles. It is a counter-trend rally. For the bulls, it's important to hold that 82-86 mark. That's a 200-day moving average. Today, it will be crucial to hold that and not fall below that. The other thing is what's happening from the FI data. Yesterday, there was cash market buying, a bit only, about 170 crore. But if you take a look at what's happening in the option side, and that's something that I've been reading for the last couple of days, the India risk is just not falling. You know, it's not the fall in the India risk is not concurrent with the kind of rise that we have seen. It's not in line. The India risk yesterday was also down only 2.5%. Why is that? That's because at every rally, there's heavy put buying that's taking place. Yesterday also, FIs net worth about close to 1,000 crores in index options, and most of that was from 8,000 to 8,200 crores. All these crores added a lot of open interest. In layman terms, it means that, you know, when the market rallies, you're going to buy some of these options. Good options because you believe that the market is going to fall. The other point is, and just to carry forward, let us the point on CPI and not too many people taking positions on that. My point is that, you know, last time when we had a rate cut, the market actually dropped out. And there's only one or two more rate cuts maybe now left in the system. So even if the CPI data is really good, we really have to confirm that what would that mean in terms of further rate cuts, and would that mean that the last of the rate cuts is actually also out of system? So that's something that a lot of people here in Delhi are talking about. But I'm sure that Lada is a good expert on that. But the sense I get when I talk to a lot of people here is that rate cut as an incremental trigger may not have too much value for the market from here on.
So actually